Unfortunately, diseases like measles are still out there. We had numerous outbreaks across the country in 2014, and in the news most recently was the outbreak in Disneyland. And that starkly shows how important that we continue to vaccinate people against these vaccine-preventable diseases. Measles can actually be quite a serious illness in any aged person. While some side effects might be mild, like diarrhea or ear infections, there actually can be quite serious consequences like pneumonia, swelling of the brain or encephalitis, seizures, profound hearing loss, and even death. While vaccines aren't 100% effective, the measles vaccine is very effective. After the first dose, which is given to children between 12 and 15 months of age, 95% of children will be immune to measles. And after the second dose, given at 4 to 6 years of age, nearly all of them will be immune. While it's important for children to be healthy, and we certainly want children to have a healthy diet and get exercise, being healthy will not prevent someone from contracting measles if they're exposed and unvaccinated. While measles isn't endemic in the US anymore, it is common in other countries. And so people who are either traveling from those countries or who travel from the US to those countries and come back and are infected with measles can then spread it in the US. And that is what has happened in some of these outbreaks. And unfortunately, measles is incredibly contagious. And so even someone who enters a room 2 hours after someone who had measles was in that room, they can contract the illness. And 90% of people who are susceptible to measles who are exposed will actually come down with measles. So an infant's immune system is actually able to handle coming in contact with huge amounts of foreign material. In fact, a baby crawling across the floor will come in contact with so many different things the immune system will respond to, and far more things than are in a vaccine. Most side effects in vaccines are minor, such as a fever or a sore arm, and more serious adverse reactions are actually quite uncommon. What we do know, though, over numerous studies, that there is no relationship between vaccines and autism or vaccines and sudden infant death syndrome.